And a reminder, Minneapolis and St. Paul are in their second set of snow emergencies that went into effect last night, meaning cars are towed if they're parked on the emergency routes. We have more information on our website, care11.com.
Several units were called early this morning to a house fire in the 400 block of West 104th Street in Bloomington. It was a two alarm fire that is now under control. No one was injured. Fire officials are investigating the cause, and the Red Cross is assisting the homeowners.
There's a new battle in the fight against opioid addiction. The FDA is ramping up its warning about kratom, a popular herbal supplement that's become easier to get in recent years.
The FDA says kratom can be linked to 44 deaths, and they're calling it an opioid. Ellery McArdle tells us about its growing reach right here in Minnesota.
This is kratom. It's a tree grown in Southeast Asia, but most people see it once it's made into capsules and sold in stores or online. Many people swear by it, saying it treats pain and opioid addiction, but the FDA warns it can kill.
So it's widely available, first of all, and second of all, it's marketed in an innocent way. It seems natural. It seems they even used to call it recreational.
But don't be fooled. Kratom can be dangerous. It's on the Drug Enforcement Administration's concern list, and the FDA says it should not be used to treat any medical condition.
I'm actually most concerned with a naive user as a gateway drug.
Tim Walsh knows about kratom. His team at Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge has been tracking it, and yes, he says, there are Minnesotans addicted to it.
We had one client who spent $40,000, and he was very concerned about his addiction.
In the past 5 years, more exposures were reported at the Minnesota Poison Control System, at least 18 cases last year. In small doses, kratom can act like a stimulant, but in high doses, more like a sedative. While some call it herbal, Walsh warns that's not the right word to use.
I would treat it as an addictive substance and something that can lead to other addictions as well.
The FDA is still doing research on kratom, but insists there's no good evidence to support the claim that it's okay to use for opioid addiction. Back to you.
Thank you, Ellery. Senator Amy Klobuchar is promoting a new law targeted at helping people with ALS and Parkinson's disease. Minnesota's senior senator speaking yesterday at the U of M. Klobuchar has introduced a bipartisan bill intended to give better access to speech-generating devices. Those devices help people with ALS and Parkinson's communicate when their vocal abilities deteriorate. But prior to the law, those devices weren't always covered under Medicare.
Patients would lose access to speech-generating devices if they entered a nursing home or another facility, even for a short period of time.
The bill permanently expands a law passed in 2015, helped at giving people with degenerative diseases assistance. New this morning, the American Academy of Pediatrics has updated its guidelines on teen depression. The group says all kids over age 12 should undergo depression screening at regular wellness checkups. The guidelines also recommend developing a safety plan as needed, including restrictions on any firearms in the home.
The University of Minnesota has decided to delay the closure of its child care center. Earlier this month, parents delivered a petition to the U's president with nearly 3,000 signatures on it, all opposed to having the 45-year-old daycare close next year due to budgeting issues. President Eric Kaler now says the U will keep the center open for, quote, as long as needed to develop alternatives.
Well, the closing ceremony for the 2018 Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang, South Korea last night, seen right here in primetime on Care 11. You can see everybody's favorite Tongan flag bearer again shirtless and wearing the traditional grass skirt, despite the cold, up on the stage with Lindsey Vonn. The ceremony wrapped up the 2 weeks of athletic competition, but the big news, especially for Minnesotans, was that Team USA's flag bearer was Afton gold medalist Jesse Diggins. Jesse, of course, won the United States' first ever cross-country skiing Olympic gold medal last week.
And as you just mentioned, she got to carry the flag in the closing ceremony, and it was something her family was very eager to see. Erin McCarl joins us more on the viewing party last night with both her mom and dad.
Yeah, good morning, guys. How cool, right? Yeah. Awesome to see her do that. And that watch party was in Stillwater last night. Her parents, Clay and Deb, say they're still on cloud nine over her success. Carrying that flag at the closing ceremony, they say, was right up there with watching her win a gold medal. So here she is during that ceremony. Jesse Diggins all smiles while carrying the U.S. flag. She was chosen to do this by her fellow Olympians. Her parents were surrounded last night by a cheering crowd while watching that ceremony. They say Jessie has worked so hard, so to accomplish what she did in Pyeongchang, it's a dream come true.
The great part about Jessie is that nobody works harder than her and nobody's happier to do it. She's just like, I'm working hard all the time and I love it because I'm doing what I love and I'm getting better and I'm excited about it.
Well, you can bet Diggins will get a big welcome home when she returns to Afton. The city will likely declare it Jessie Diggins Day at some point. And Selma's Ice Cream Parlor is reportedly planning to release a special ice cream flavor in her honor. Not bad, Alicia.
Very good stuff. All right, Ellery, thank you. And it was the Merrick Curl on ice, the big weekend win for the U.S. men's curling team, getting gold against Sweden. And they're on their way back home. They arrive around 5 tonight at the Duluth Airport.
The team's exciting gold medal match happened early Saturday morning, yet many in Minnesota opted to stay up to watch that match, as Team USA was almost entirely Minnesotan. Overnight, the team skipper, John Schuster, tweeted out that someone who was at that gold medal match heard he was on their flight and offered Schuster a first-class seat. Schuster says he plans to use the gift wisely and work on getting some much-needed sleep.
Well, now it's on to Tokyo for the Summer Olympics in 2020. It's the second time the Olympics have been hosted by Japan. The last time was 1964. This time, there will be four new sports: surfing, climbing, karate, and skateboarding. And Beijing will host their second Olympics, this time in winter of 2022. They'll be the first city to host both Summer and Winter Olympics. Ice sports will be held in former venues from the 2008 Games, and two other regions will be developed to handle snow and mountain sports. There you go. Moving on to the next ones.
Cool.
No rest.
Nah.
And the air quality in Beijing has improved a lot since those last games, so we'll see.
There you go.
For real?
Yeah, for real. They're taking some major measures. Yeah.
Much needed.
Much needed.
Yes.
And proof that if you do something, you know, you can actually make a difference.
Cool.
We got temperatures this morning starting out in the teens to around 20 degrees at the airport, 12 in South St. Paul. We do have a few single digits, Buffalo and St. Cloud both at 8 and 5 respectively. We'll see highs up into the upper 30s. Lots of sunshine. Nice day of thawing, but not too warm. Can still play out in the snow.
Yes.
All right, Sven, thank you. We did have a crash pop up 35W southbound near Highway 10. I'll try to pull it up here on my traffic cameras in just a little bit and show you guys that crash. It is starting to cause just a minor slowdown for folks this morning, but that is the only crash I'm tracking at this time.
All right, thank you, Alicia. Still to come on Sunrise, the Twins make a deal during spring training as we count down to the season opener. And the team also wondering what's next after Jimmy Butler undergoes knee surgery, leaving the rest of his season and perhaps theirs in doubt. Plus,
we're hoping to give you another tool to help the body not fight your weight loss attempts.
A pill that could change weight loss, testing going on right now for a fat burner that could save lives.